Creativity has been a must during the pandemic. The Artist Council has a plan to help you overcome any creativity obstacles with some interesting virtual workshops through April. Now, here this morning is the Council's Educational and Professional Development Director, Chris Kozin. Welcome, Chris. It's good to have you with us.
Thanks, Joe. Happy New Year.
Well, same to you. The Artist Council is always looking for ways to find their inner creativity, and you found a new one.
You know, there's a lot of stress with COVID in this whole isolation business, and we know creativity helps relieve stress. So our first thing was to try to get something up and running quickly. So we launched programming as early as last July.
You are an artist. You've enlisted so many people from actually now around the country and probably even around the world to help out with these workshops.
I'm familiar with a lot of the artists who are part of the team that work with Golden. So I reached out to them and asked them and a number of people that I know here in the Valley to join the team this year for the spring and summer activities. So we've got people from all over, and we're excited about the program. It's diverse and interesting, and some are challenging, some are more friendly for people who want to start out.
And so talk to me about some of the other workshops that will be out there, the different types of art that these instructors will be helping people with.
Watercolor class on local birds, which is time to sort of coincide with the time when a lot of birders come to the area. We've got a class on learning to do art on the computer or on an iPad, taught by a local artist, Pat Coday, a very familiar artist to our area. And she's doing two sessions, one on the beginning and one for the intermediate and advanced students. We have chalk and pastel work. We have acrylic artists. We have printmaking on the list.
If I sign up for one and say I want to work in chalk, do I create something and then show it to the teacher? How does that work?
Well, people have gotten very creative about how to use Zoom and video teaching. So it's very experiential. Lots of times there's a demonstration, and then the instructor will show what's needs to be done and explain what needs to be done, and then ask the people that are participating to work along with them.
There's probably a lot of creativity in each and every one of us, but we just need that kind of push to really bring that creativity out.
Yes, and a lot of people, I think, during COVID have gotten away or sort of haven't had the interaction which comes with sometimes going to an art class or meeting with friends to do art.
Well, it's good to know that art doesn't stop. So if somebody wants to sign up for either maybe just the lecture or wants to sign up for one of the classes, how do they do it?
Go straight to the Artist Council website, www.artistcouncil.com, and that's artist with an S. And every class listing, there's a link to an Eventbrite site, which is for each class, and then you can sign up directly through Eventbrite.
Well, it sounds like it's a lot of fun, and it's a way for people to kind of break their creativity barrier and get back to what they love to do. And as you say, I think it really kind of is therapeutic in so many ways.
In so many ways. We have people that have come back and say, I just had stopped painting, and I'm so glad to have these opportunities to see people and get together with people over an artistic activity.
All right. Well, Chris, good luck with this. We appreciate you being with us this morning.
Thank you. Can I just mention that people should keep an eye out for our ACE show that's coming up. It's called Reflections. That'll be in the spring. So keep an eye out on the website for that, and be sure to check it out.
All right, for sure. We appreciate it.
Thank you. Happy New Year again, everybody.
Same to you. And keep it right there. We'll be right back.